The FCT Division of the Federal High Court has ordered Nigeria Secret Police, the Department of State Services, DSS, to grant incarcerated leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, Ipob, Nnamdi Kanu, access to his team of physicians. Delivering the judgment, Justice Binta Nyako held that Kanu retains the right to consult his preferred medical practitioners while dismissing the objection of DSS, which argued that Kanu's health was not in danger and that he was receiving adequate attention from their team of doctors. The judge further ordered that the Ipob leader's doctors and DSS officials should be present whenever a medical examination is conducted on him outside the agency's detention facilities. Speaking after the judgment, counsel to Nnamdi Kanu, Mike Ozekome-san, said the court granted all the reliefs as requested by his client while taking a trip down the memory lane to narrate the twists and turns of the case. The legal luminary echoed the position of the court, which granted Kanu access to his medical doctors while stressing that the ruling empowers Kanu's team of doctors to be present whenever medical examination is being conducted on the Ipob leader.
The court agreed with us that the reliefs we asked for must be granted, and the judge granted. What were these reliefs? That Nnamdi Kanu be allowed access to medical doctors of his own choice, as earlier also ruled by this honorable court. Since October 2021, but which ruling was continuously, serially, and contumaciously breached by the SSS. Today, the court ruled that he was entitled to have access to his medical practitioners of his own choice, and that these medical practitioners should be present whenever any examination or procedure is to be done on Mazi Nnamdi Kanu outside the facilities of the SSS.
Ozekome further stressed how they resorted to using the order of mandamus to compel Nigeria's domestic intelligence agency to obey previous court orders.
The case before this court today was for an order of mandamus to compel a public agency, which is the DSS, to carry out its duty, which it has refused to carry out as laid down by law, after we wrote them letters, two letters, in October and November 2022, urging them to carry out what the court has today granted. They refused.
He clarified that Kanu is not a party to the sit-at-home policy being enforced in part of Southeast by some groups, as he pointed out that his client firmly believes in the socio-economic development of the region.
He has told me as his lead counsel, as his lawyer, that he does not believe in it, that he cannot be fighting for his people and be shutting down their economy. How do they feed? How would they train their children? Many a time he cried to me in my presence that he wants to be released so that he can hold a world press conference and address the Indigbos and the Alaigbos and the entire world to say, don't stay at home on Mondays, go about your normal duties, work. Because the Bible tells us it is upon the fruits of your hand. I will bless you the labor of your hands. So I'm now re-echoing it again and again, what Nnamdi Kanu has told me. He does not believe in that seat at home on Mondays, which cripples the social, economic, cultural, political life of the people.
The leader of Ipob, Nnamdi Kanu, has been in detention since 2021 after he was flown into the country on 27th June of the same year, purportedly from Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. In Abuja, Nigeria's capital, Abiodun Mohammed, Top Accolade News.